aboard. Hit the road. All the bullshit can't be ignored. It's hard to place in my face. No emotion. All the problems make me wanna go. Like a bad girl straight to video. Welcome to the Unboxing Hour. I am your host, the King of YouTube, Pikachu Allspark. Is that a hair? Is that a fucking hair? No, it's not a hair. What is that? I didn't mark on it with like a pencil or anything. Is that a fold? How did that get a fold? Boom. This is the Lego City number, focus you whore. Number 60251, Monster Truck. Yes, that's 55 pieces. This, I recently found this in, get this, not Walmart. Yes, Walmart's usually where I find all the Legos at, but, no, this one was in a different store. A store I will not say the name of. Because it's a local place, and I don't want to dox myself, you see. Well, it's not that local, but, you know, only a select group of people have heard of it. Millions of people have heard of it, but only a select millions. So, try to narrow it down from that. Anyways, yes, here's the back, which I've been showing you for like 10 seconds. And of course, we're going to show you all the sides. So, I saw a monster truck, and I jumped at the opportunity to get this. Absolutely leaped. Because as you know, I'm a Lego boy, and I make Lego SpongeBob videos, and a new one is coming, and it will not involve this, but the one after that, oh, I've got an idea for this, and of course I forgot the YouTuber knife, so let me just talk for a few seconds while I reach off set to get it. Oh, no, can't have that, no, got a little American flag there, I don't want it to fall. Yes, anyways, let's unsheath this so we can get to tape cutting. Where's the tape? Oh, this is one of those where I'm supposed to do that, huh? No, that damages the box. I'm not doing that. He may be able to guess, but I'm not a fan of box damaging. So, you know, if there's tape, I would rather just cut that. I'm cutting through something. Is there tape on the other side of the box? Does the other side of the box have tape? What the fuck? Did that open it? It's glued on. I unboxed a Lego set. I unboxed the fucking ice cream truck set this year. It was not glued on. That fucking thing was taped. Why is this not taped? What are you doing, Lego? What the fuck are you doing? Wait, what's the year on this set? 2020. It's this year. Same year as the ice cream truck set. What are you doing, Lego? I'm used to you being taped. Why are you not taped? Like, don't go and radically change your packaging. What the fuck is this? Why was this glued? Fuck that. So yes, do I need to keep this out, or I might have to get the scissors, actually. Why didn't I prepare? Why didn't I just sit down and start doing this? Whoa. There we go, it's out. Let's get that sweet, sweet inside the box shot. Probably should have got this while the bags were still in it, but, eh. Yeah, there we go, empty box. And let's set that off camera. And have ourselves a look-see at the rest. Here are the instructions. Small instruction booklet for a small set. On the back, you could win if you take a survey on Lego.com, which I will not do. And there's two bags. A big one, Focus. There we go. And a little one. Yeah, it looks like the minifigure pieces are divided between the bags, and I don't like it when they do that. So yeah, it's, whoa, I just dropped a knife on myself. Man, that could have been catastrophic. Yeah, anyways, yeah, I'm not doing that, so let's get the scissors right now. And we are back. These good old Dollar Tree scissors I got back in 2017. They are what will cut through the bag. Yeah, and you gotta cut through the other one too. And then, once these bags are cut through, I will dump them all into one pile. Yeah, I think that one's cut enough. So, obviously we're going to dump the little bag first. So let's do it. Easy. And why am I dumping them all into one pile? Isn't that an unprofessional way to build or something? Let's just sheath the YouTuber knife before we go anymore. Because I'm going to try to put it on myself, so I don't want to be cut while I'm trying to build. So yes, is that an unprofessional way to do things? Maybe. I don't know, I just like the big pile, you know? This is how I always do it. This is how I've been doing Legos for 11 years. So, I'm just going to keep doing it this way, you know? So yes, here's the pile. Minifigure torso, a clear visor. Always like the clear pieces in Lego, those are amazing. And you got to see my fingernail, isn't that amazing too? Here's a big wheel. Yeah. Good old rubber tire. Okay, this is getting... my commentary's getting boring. Let's cut to the built product. Wait, hold on. Hold on, before we do that, look. This isn't a sticker, it's printed. Isn't that amazing? Okay, now let's cut to the built product. Boom, here it is. The monster truck. Yes, this thing is epic, I shall say. So it did come with some extra pieces. A second visor, one of these clear yellow ones. It's yellow, but also clear. Does that say Lego in it? Oh, no, it doesn't say Lego in it. And one of these studs, which for some odd reason is hollow. Yeah, two of these are on the back of it as well, as you can see. Why are those hollow now? I don't know. I remember studs like that didn't used to be hollow, but those were, so... I like this. It's a cool little monster truck here, and it can be quite useful to me. So let's go into what I don't like. The fact that the back is completely open. Like, what is this? Why is this open? Look, my finger's in it. My finger's driving the monster truck. But seriously though, why is there no back in this? Like, what is that? Who the fuck thought that was a good idea to not put a back in this thing? So let's put the minifigure in it, but first, let's show you the minifigure. He's wearing this racing attire, monster truck attire. The back of the torso does have the same design. Well, not the same design, but you know, the same design scheme, I guess. You know what I mean. Removing the helmet, we get this face. And I believe that's a new face to me. I don't have a face like that, I don't think. There's nothing on the back. So yeah, so let's re-helmet the guy. Because he's going to drive the monster truck. Let's get... Whoa. And he fell in. Yeah, so let's put him in there. There's no chair in this one. I like when the vehicles come with chairs. A lot of the vehicles don't come with chairs, though. But hey, it does have a steering wheel. It's a gray one. And let's get ourselves a view of the cockpit without the minifigure in it. If I can. Come out. There we go. Yes, I did just force this minifigure to come out. You see, that was a gay joke. I'm not afraid to make gay jokes, because I'm not a pussy. Anyways, here's the cockpit. Yeah, nothing all that special. There's no doors on this. That's another thing I don't like about it. But this set does have too many pluses to let a few little things get in my way of liking it. First, it has this bit of front design here that's amazing. And then we have the printed hood bit here. It's a monster truck that actually got the monster printing on it. You know, I believe that the previous LEGO monster trucks I've owned in the past, they just looked like big trucks, so you know. Actually trying to make this one look like a monster is great. Especially since real monster trucks often look like monsters these days, I believe. Although I haven't really been paying much attention to monster trucks ever throughout my entire life. So that's another good thing is these bits here, how am I supposed to call those things? Like, they're not horns, are they? Are those horns? Scales? Whatever I'm supposed to call them, they're nice. And yeah, it's a good set. I like it, you know. You can have some great monster truck fun with this. I don't know what else to say. As you can tell, I'm not that great of a reviewer. I've never been that great of a reviewer, you know. But I do like to get Legos and take them out of the box and play with them. You know, some dickhead's probably gonna keep this in a box for 10 years and then sell it for $1 million. And to that guy, I say, you're a fucking idiot. Because I get to have monster truck fun, and you're just waiting for green rectangles. Don't get me wrong, I like green rectangles too. You know, they're one of the greatest things that has ever been invented. Money is, but you know, if I had to choose between a bunch of money in 10 years or playing with this thing right now, I think I'd play with this LEGO set right now. And that was the unboxing hour. And until next week, all hail the king. Like a bad girl straight to